Pranam Acharya ji. The shlok being quoted is, through the grace of God alone, the desire for non-duality arises in wise men to save them from great fear. Then she is saying, the verses sound nice, but I am not one with them. I see my mind is just playing with whatever it reads and hears. Advait talks about the ultimate truth, but how do I live this truth? How do I see it as me? Pay the price, Taruna. You are asking for too much of a discount. Stuff doesn't come so cheap. You haven't even fully paid the first installment, and you are asking for the whole consignment to be delivered. You are saying you want the entire truth. And how much price have you paid till now? The fellow hasn't started paying the EMIs of the house. Not even the first EMI has been paid. And he's eager to move in. Doesn't happen this way. Keep paying the price. And you know what the price is. The price is you. Keep paying the price. It's great that you are in love with grace, God, Advait, truth, the ultimate. It's great that you want to be one with the verses. But merely wanting won't suffice. You have to back your desire with solid display. Display your commitment. Pay with your life. Keep swiping. Till the limit is exhausted. It's dishonesty to not pay fully and yet express dissatisfaction that the fruit has not fully arrived. If you will say that you want the full truth, I will say that you must make the full payment. Make the full payment. The truth respects your wish. It asks you, how much do you want? And you answer through your life. Your life is the payment. God looks at the quantum of the payment made by you, and accordingly He dispatches the good. Shops dispatch goods. God dispatches the good. But in either case, a lot depends on the payment made by you. Before you complain that you aren't receiving, ask yourself, do you even intend to receive? Had you really intended to receive, you would have made space for the good to arrive. What you are asking for is tremendous, voluminous. It can arrive in your life only if you have firstly cleared space for it. The goods that are cleared off are the payment that you make. If your life space, if your mental space is occupied with stuff, then the truth cannot arrive. Where will it sit? It's huge. It's humongous. It consumes all the space. And you are intent that you must keep your little toys. And if your space is devoted to your little toys, why are you even talking of the truth? Make space, make space. There was a little girl, you know. She found that in the back room, which was being used as a store, a lot of junk had accumulated. A hell lot of junk. So what did she do? She called a kabadi wala, a junk collector. And sold away all the junk. And by selling away all the junk, she got some money. And with that money, she bought two little flower vases containing little fragrant flowers and kept in that free and open space. Sell away the junk, make the payment. That will firstly clear up space, secondly give you enough to get little flowers. Mm-hmm.